This is an example of a gamma scan of a packed tower, where it was desired to determine the liquid vapor distribution quality through the beds. As shown in this scan orientation diagram, four consecutive scans were performed rather than just one, and the results of the four scans are then compared to each other. If the packed sections are operating normally, the four scans should look similar through the packing when overlaid. This view provides the results of the scans. An elevation view taken from the tower drawings is provided on the right, and the results of the scan in the form of a density plot will be displayed on the left. Although the entire tower was scanned, for the purposes of this example, we are just focusing on two of the packed beds. As with each of the scans, a radioactive source and a detector are lowered down opposite sides of the tower to produce a density profile. Here we can see absorptions for the distributor, the upper packed bed, and the lower packed bed. The second scan shows a density profile similar to the first scan. The third scan is interesting though, as the profile through the upper bed is very consistent with the previous scans, but the profile through the lower bed is much more dense, indicating liquid channeling and/or fouling. And again, on the fourth scan, the profile for the top bed is very uniform, but in the lower bed, the fourth scan is much less dense. So, the upper packed bed showed good distribution, but the lower bed showed poor distribution, with a liquid bias on the green scan and a vapor bias on the blue one. Thus, by performing four scans, a 2x2 grid scan on the tower, we are able to detect maldistribution through the packing, which would not be captured by a single scan on the tower. In summary, the grid scan revealed that the upper bed was operating with good distribution, but the lower bed had poor distribution, maldistribution, channeling, whatever you'd like to call it. Thank you for your interest in tower scan.